As COVID-19 cases surged in March and April, there was a scramble to secure protective equipment for healthcare workers on the front lines. But what about changes to the medical spaces themselves to protect both workers and patients? NewsHour Weekend's Christopher Booker has a look at one hospital retrofitting its spaces to fight the virus.
On the afternoon of April 15, 2013, two pressure cooker bombs detonated near the finish line of the Boston Marathon, killing three and injuring hundreds. Within minutes, the hospitals in the area were flooded with patients and quickly responded.
The hypotheticals were the 9/11 type of hypothetical, the Boston Marathon disaster, you know, that tragedy in which there was a huge influx of critically ill people that were going to come in. You know, that is absolutely in place.
According to Dr. John Bukovalis of Mount Sinai Hospital, trauma centers prepare for these mass casualty events. What isn't in place are plans for how hospitals need to physically change to respond to what the globe is facing now, the outbreak of an airborne pandemic disease.
One of the big takeaways is that our medical system is not designed to manage a surge of a pandemic of this nature. And that should kind of awaken all of us to the challenges we have of our healthcare infrastructure, full stop.
Michael Murphy is the executive director of the socially minded architecture and design collective, Mass Design Group.
Our hospitals are designed, you know, with very tight margins to fill beds and have them largely full all the time. They're not designed to have excess of beds. And what that means during this outbreak and surge is that the system itself has been pushed to its limits.
At Dr. Bukovalis Hospital in New York, the medical center was forced to rapidly transition traditional care spaces to wards exclusively for COVID-19 patients.
Even at baseline, the clinical world has not thought very deliberately about the built environment.
As the pandemic grew, the hospital brought in Dr. Neil Shah of the Global Health Innovation Center, Ariadne Labs, as well as architect Michael Murphy to study how a hospital redesign could keep patients and health workers safe.
Basically, every delivery system in the country and in the world had to adapt on the fly. And New York City at Mount Sinai Hospital was literal ground zero for this global pandemic for a couple weeks. And it was just an extraordinary opportunity to try to figure out how we not only learn what Mount Sinai is doing, but create lessons for the rest of the world very quickly.
Over a three-week period in early April, Mount Sinai used remote observers to examine the various spatial changes the hospital implemented. Using GoPro cameras, doctors walked through the medical units to give the outside clinicians and designers a sense of the infection control designs.
We took video, we interviewed people, and they could then peer in. And that allowed us to make the observations incredibly quickly.
What were some of those key data points that you learned from this study as it relates to the design of the hospital?
Infection control protocols usually are used to protect patients. In this situation, we have to protect everyone, providers, the people that did environmental services, the people that were moving in and out of the clerks and things like that. So there's a lot of administrative support staff. So it's a whole different mindset.
The shift in mindset meant making strategic decisions that could work within the structure of decades-old buildings. IV machines that typically sit inside a patient's room were moved out into hallways to minimize medical staff interacting with infected patients. For contagious diseases like COVID-19, the standard of care is negative pressure isolation rooms, but hospitals typically don't have very many. During the surge of COVID-19 patients, Mount Sinai converted 260 regular rooms to specialized negative pressure isolation rooms.
So we're also able to see where clinicians were also putting tape on the floor, putting up visual cues to try to articulate to staff when they were walking into a red zone, a contaminated zone, when they were leaving that zone, so that we could be more cognizant of the amount of PPE that we were wearing. And those simple spatial markers are really essential nudges that could allow us to remind ourselves, hey, we're entering a more dangerous zone, be more protected.
Mass Design Group has worked in the middle of epidemics in the past. In 2015, it designed a hospital to help fight the cholera outbreak in Haiti. And during the 2014 Ebola crisis in West Africa, the firm developed a set of national standards for health infrastructure design in Liberia. Murphy says these experiences influence the way he thinks about physical space and how it impacts health. What changes have been made since your study?
I would say one of the fundamental things that's changed is not just for hospitals, but for all of us. Is this incredible spatial awareness. Are we going to be contaminated by leaving our house? Are we going to contaminate others? And that incredible spatial cognition that the spaces around us are potentially infectious or potentially healthier is a significant paradigm shift in the way we think about the world around us, I think, and should and will shape the way we design hospitals a little bit more deliberately in the future. And how we can design for trust are going to be crucial for every one of our public spaces.